Welcome to the Excel Tips Companion videos. My name is Neale Blackwood, and today we're going to look at a relatively new feature in Excel, which allows you to import share prices and other information directly into Excel. So it's on the data ribbon, and they're called data types. There's four types listed. We're going to look at the stocks and the currencies, and I might briefly just show you the geography as well. Organization. Now that is a feature that's driven by Power BI. So it is something that is exciting. I'm not going to cover it today, but it requires Power BI. And what you can do is set up data types within your organization. And when you see how powerful these are, you'll see why that's so exciting. Okay, so let's have a look at the stocks. So I'm just going to enter in stock in cell A1, and I'm going to enter a code. Now, the code starts with the stock exchange, so XASX, and then the colon, and then the code for the particular share, so WBC. So I'm going to use Westpac as an example. So I'm just going to press enter. I'm going to select the cell and go up to the data types and select stocks. So convert to stocks. Now that's going to look at the code and figure out where we want to get it from, so which stock exchange, and bring the name in. So Westpac Banking Corp, then it's got that code following it in brackets. Now, that also automatically brings up a disclaimer, which you can see across the top here, saying that this is market information is provided as is and not for professional or trading purposes or advice. So that's Microsoft, that's the disclaimer there. So that's the name. So I'm just gonna widen this a little bit. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna convert this, let's do a couple of others. So I might copy this down. And I'm gonna type in XASX colon, and let's do CBA. There we go. Copy it down again. And let's do ANZ. So XASX colon ANZ. Okay, so there's the three of the big banks there listed. Now I'm gonna make this a formatted table. Formatted tables are really powerful, and the data types feature takes advantage of them. So you can click anywhere here. I'm gonna go back to home, and I'm gonna use format as table. I'll just pick a blue, and it confirms that there's a header row, and there we go. Now, watch what I can do here. I wanna bring in the price. So if I type in price in cell B1, so B1 is like the header row, and when I hit enter, you can sort of already see that it's doing something a little bit different here with the stock. So when I hit enter, it automatically creates a formula for me in cell B2 and at stock. So that's saying basically grab the stock, whatever's in the stock column, on the same row, so the at symbol means on the same row, and then the full stop price. So that's part of the data types functionality, and that brings in the price. I'll just close this disclaimer. I'll tick that, close the disclaimer. So you can type in one of the fields that are associated with the data type. So price is one of them. You can see a list of all of them. I'll show you that a little bit later, but we might want to find out the currency. So you can actually just go here and type it in. So what I can do is go equals and then click on the at stock. And then if I hit full stop, that gives me that listing of all of those entries. Now I might want the currency, so I can click on that or double click and hit enter. It needs a column, so I'll then call that currency. I could have typed currency into there as well, but I thought I'd show you how you can build it up and also see the list of some of the entries that you can actually bring in. Okay, so one of the other things that you can access using data types is currency. We might want to, for example, bring in some other shares and maybe from other stock exchanges which have other currencies. So let's have a play with those. So I'm going to type in XNZE, so that's New Zealand, and then the colon, and then let's bring in WBC from there. We could also bring in a New York one, so XNYS colon, and let's bring in IBM. Okay, and there we go. You may have seen temporarily the field error pop up, which is basically just bringing the data in. So we can see here that we have other currencies for New Zealand dollar and the US dollar. So let's say we want to go and convert these prices to Australian dollars. So I'm going to go to a separate sheet and create another little table. So this time I want to use NZD to AUD. And I need to tell it that it's a currency. So it's figured it out. When you get the little icon next to it, that means it's figured it out. So I'm just going to copy that down to there. And then I'm going to go with US dollars to Australian dollars. And there we go. So again, I'm going to make this a little table. So format as table, I'll go with green for this one. There we go. And so I can type in price here as well. And there we go. So on the day that I am doing this video, they're the current currency conversions for New Zealand dollars and US dollars. One thing to notice here as well, there's been a format automatically applied to these two cells. I didn't do the dollar sign. Funnily enough, I don't like this particular format. And this is the accounting format you can see up the top here. What I prefer to use is the currency format. That puts the dollar sign next to the numbers, whereas the accounting format puts the dollar sign on the far left. Okay, so now what I want to do is to make this a little bit easier to look up, because I need to look up the codes for the New Zealand dollar and the US dollar. So I'm going to put in a code here. I want to extract out the code. Now, it looks like there's this entry in there, but because this is a data type, you do need to use a special code to actually get the symbols. It's called the ticker symbol to get the code. So here we go. So equals left and exchange rates. Press the full stop. And what we want is what's called the ticker symbol. So it's the very last entry. And that's comma 3. So we want to grab the first three characters from the ticker symbol, which is that basically NZD entry. So that gives us a code we can look up in the other table. So let's go back to that table. We can do a formula that we're going to bring in the rate if we need it. Obviously, if we're in Australian dollars, we don't need the rate. Let's do it. So we'll bring in the exchange rate. There. And so the formula here is going to be equals if, and then we're going to click on the currency, equals, use the quotation marks. So if it's AUD, then we're just going to use a 1 because there's no conversion required. Otherwise, comma, we're going to use an XLOOKUP. You could use you couldn't use a VLOOKUP. You could use an index match. We're going to use an XLOOKUP, which is again, a relatively new function. So the currency, AUD, is what we want to look up. And then we're going to go to our tables here and select that. Oh, that's right. In the example, I've actually named this table. So I'll go back and do that, and I'll show you how you can name a table. So at the moment, it's called Table 2 Code. And we want to return the price. And if we can't find anything, we're going to bring in a zero. So that's the XLOOKUP saying, look up the currency in the code column in table two. And if you find it, bring in the price column from table two. So click that. There we go. There's all the ones. Let's go and rename the table. I'll show you where you can do that. So that's the table. When you're inside a formatted table, you get the table design. So I'll call that TBL rates. I tend to use a prefix on my table names of TBL, just so it sort of differentiates it from range names, which I use a lot of. And so there we are. We have the exchange rate coming in. So what we can do then is we can call this price in AUD, and then just do a multiplication of that times the price. Cool. So we can make these a bit wider. And so that's all pretty much automated. So the exchange rate's automated, the price is automated. Every now and then you'll see the page refresh. Now, one thing I should mention is that you do need an internet connection for this to work, because it's obviously downloading the information from the internet. If you wanted to update, so all of this should update automatically. So if we go and grab in, let's say another code from New Zealand. So let's go XNZE colon, and I imagine ANZ is there as well. So there we go, ANZ Holdings in New Zealand. So it's brought the price in, New Zealand dollars, we've got the exchange rate, and we've got the value there. Just a note as well, whilst I was recording the video, there were times when there was a delay in it updating. So just be aware that there could be times when it might be slow updating the information. Just be aware that this table we're looking at here, a lot of that functionality in terms of copying down and that sort of thing is also caught up in the formatted tables feature. So formatted tables are a feature I have covered in a previous video and article, and they automatically copy the formulas down. So when I added the ANZ from New Zealand, all of these formulas automatically copied down. Again, that's part of the formatted table functionality. It's not part of the stocks functionality. So the stocks functionality is the fact that we can get the price and the currency, and the fact that it's in a formatted table means that those fields are automatically copied down. We don't need to do anything about it. So it's sort of the stocks and the formatted tables work together fairly seamlessly. Okay, so that is sort of a table-based layout using that. I'll just take you and just show you sort of another way you can use it. So let's say we just go into a cell and we'll do Westpac again. And we'll go to data and stocks. Okay, so I'll zoom in a bit to that. So when you've got a cell that has a data type in it, there is this little icon here as well. So you can click on that. And what you can say is, for example, let's say we want the 52-week high. Okay, so that's showing it to me. You can say, let's say the 52-week low. Okay, so there you can see the last 52 weeks movements. There's also, this gives you sort of the listings of all of the data that's available. But if you right click it, there is what's called a data type card. So show the data type card. So that's right clicking the cell. And this gives you a separate listing. You can make it wider, which I suppose has all the information in one spot. So you've got the currencies, the previous close, market capitalization, things like that, and a description as well. So that's in the single, it's called a card. So again, that's right clicking and choosing show data type card. So on the cell that is a that has the data type, you can see the information there as well. As well as clicking this little icon and choosing one of the entries, you can just sort of refer to that cell, so A1, and then press the full stop. And again, that will give you that listing of everything. So if we wanted the number of employees, for example, we can get that to display. So you can use either the little icon, or you can refer to the cell and press the full stop and then select the entry from the drop-down list. I thought I'd just show you quickly to finish off the other data type, which is geography. So we've seen stocks and currencies. There's also geography. So let's have a look at the, so let's go Sydney. Sydney, New South Wales. Let's see how we go there with geography. Okay, so that's picked up Sydney. If I right click and choose the show data card, we get a listing here, and I'll make it a little bit wider. So it's got there, it's got the population, tells you when the population was there, and the size, latitude, and some other information. And if Let's try Melbourne and see what that says. And there we go. We can see the same thing. 4.9 million, so just under Sydney at the moment as at 2021. So you can access some basic geography data. There's also a lot of other links here as well that are related to the particular data type that you've chosen and the entry there. You can also, it looks like you can pick up other data types, like for example, Victoria, Australia, they will also have a, you can get information on those as well. So that's under geography as a data type. Okay, so exciting times ahead with Excel with these data types. So we looked at the share price, the currencies, and the geography as well. Organizational data types, again, that's exciting. It's powered by Power BI, and that is something that you might be able to take advantage of with things like products in your systems. Okay, I hope you found that useful, and thanks for watching.